This pig's bacon was delicious, but she's alive and well, goes the headline.
Oh, God. I know where this is going.
A company called Mission Barns is cultivating pork fat in bioreactors and turning it into meatballs and other products. Honestly, they're pretty darn good. That is not me speaking. That is the journalist speaking. So let me just read a few highlighted sections and then, you know, we'll talk about it. Again, the author, Matt Simon, writes, I'm eating Dawn, the Yorkshire pig, and she's quite tasty. But don't worry, she's doing perfectly fine, traipsing around a sanctuary in upstate New York. Word is that she appreciates belly rubs and sunshine. I'm in San Francisco, at an Italian joint just south of Golden Gate Park, enjoying meatballs and bacon, not made of meat in the traditional sense, but of plants mixed with cultivated pork fat. Dawn, you see, donated a small sample of fat, which a company called Mission Barns got to proliferate in devices called bioreactors by providing nutrients like carbohydrates, amino acids, and vitamins, essentially replicating the conditions in her body. But are they? That was me, not the author. Because so much of the flavor of pork and other meats comes from the animal's fat, Mission Barns can create products like sausages and salami with plants, but make them taste darn near like sausages and salami. I'll read a few more sections here. Cultivated pork is the newest entrant in the effort to rethink meat. Just, okay.
Yeah.
Meat does not need to be rethought.
No.
I mean, we don't want CAFOs. We don't want the giant, horrendous, disgusting factory farms. But meat does not need to be rethought.
It's like thinking that joy needs to be rethought.
Totally. For years, plant-based offerings have been mimicking burgers, chicken, and fish with ever more convincing blends of proteins and fats. Convincing? I don't know. Mission Barns is one of a handful of startups taking the next step, growing real animal fat outside the animal, then marrying it with plants to create hybrids that look, cook, and taste more like what consumers have always eaten, easing the environmental and ethical costs of industrial livestock. The company says it's starting with pork because it's a large market and products like bacon are fat-rich, but its technology is cell-agnostic.
Whoa.
Mm-hmm. Meaning it could create beef and chicken, too. Okay, a little bit more here. Getting animal cells to grow outside of an animal, though, ain't easy. For one, if cells don't have anything to attach to, they die. So Mission Barns cultivator uses a sponge-like structure full of nooks and crannies that provides lots of surface area for the cells to grow. We have our media, which is just the nutrient solution that we give to these cells, said Sam Shiroki, chief technology officer at Mission Barns. We're essentially recapitulating all of the environmental cues that make cells inside the body grow fat, but outside the body. Again, the claims that it's just what the inside the body is doing. We're just doing it outside. It's fine. Nothing to see here. Trust us. And I think one more section that I wanted to read part of. Of course, in this new frontier of food, the big question is, who exactly is this for? Would a vegetarian or vegan eat cultured pork fat if it's divorced from the cruelty of factory farming? Would meat eaters be willing to give up the real thing for a facsimile? No. Mission Barns Market Research, Lee said, found that its early adopters are actually flexitarians, people who eat mostly plant-based but partake in the occasional animal product. But Lee adds that their first limited sale to the public in Berkeley included some people who called themselves vegetarians and vegans because they get to do whatever they want. And that's it. That's
all right. I have two predictions. One of them is so secure that I'm not in any way worried it will not be true,
yeah.
Which is that this stuff's going to be gross.
Yes.
Okay.
So gross. I mean, so I didn't read some of it. It's like, actually, the mouth feels pretty good. And it's like, it has a nice, like, bite. Like, I
never trusted the media and the media they're growing this. I don't trust it either.
They lie like, oh, it's just carbohydrates and amino acids. It's fine. Like, what are you doing?
All right.
What are you using? Just kind of nooks and crannies in which to grow fat and to put that into plant stuff and pretend it's a meatball.
All right. Here's one that I am prepared to wait a long time to turn out to be right about.
Okay.
That's a prediction. You heard it here first, folks.
Oh, yeah.
It's going to be carcinogenic.
Why?
Because what they allied in this presentation is that they have to overcome the hay flick limit in order to grow massive amounts of this substance. And in order to do that...
Unless they're constantly harvesting new fat.
So...
Then that increases
the number of animals you need.
Yeah, it's not going to be sustainable if they're constantly harvesting new fat. So if they're using a single pull of fat to grow much, 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 much more fat, then Good.
Then they're going to be using telomerase or some sort of a trick to increase the length of telomeres. And the chances that that is not going to be in the meat are...
The meatballs.
Correct. So there's a question about A, how are they doing it? That's interesting. I'd love to know.
How are they doing what?
How are they overcoming the hay flick limit? Are they dumping telomerase on it? Are they editing the genes so that telomerase is turned on? Or what are they doing?
I mean, it could honestly be sort of like what happened in the Jax labs where, you know, they've got fat that does and does not last longer. And the fat that lasts longer, they're just using that.
Oh.
I don't know. It's just that that's the better fat for us. And so it's inadvertent selective pressure that they are.
Yeah, but then you know what you're describing.
What?
You're describing growing tumors on the wall and then selling it as if it were food, which isn't any better because.
But it's tumors in nooks and crannies, so that's cuter.
What do we find in tumors that we don't find in the rest of the body is we find active telomerase. So I think.
God.
Folks.
It's so horrifying.
I am really not suicidal, nor am I planning to become suicidal.
Nope.
So the fact that I have this awkward insight into what their industry is probably doing hopefully will not result in the industry taking up arms against me. But in any case, yeah, I wouldn't touch this stuff with a barge pole. And if I touched it with a barge pole, I wouldn't touch it with a barge pole. But if I made the mistake of touching it with a barge pole, I would... wash the barge pole before eating anything off of it.
It's not a eating implement, but...
Let's put it this way. You have to really run out of other eating implements before you start using a barge pole.
Fingers first.
Probably a better plan. But in any case, yeah, I think okay. Carcinogenicity is the thing to watch.
That's I did not see that coming. That's fascinating because I think you're right. Just to replay the argument... fat is not going to replicate endlessly. Either they are constantly going back to animals and pulling more fat, which means it's the operation is not going to scale.
Yep.
Without using a whole lot of animals, who were upstate getting sunshine and belly rubs, or they are doing something else to evade the hay flick limit, and it may just be this like, oh, I don't know, that fat just works better. In which case, they're growing tumor fat.
Yep.
Or they're doing something else. We don't know what it is, but they've still got. Fat that is not where it would be if it were coming out of a pig that had lived a natural life.
Yep. All right. Two other points. One, even if the carcinogenicity is not the case with fat for some reason, fat is a special tissue. It's possible.
Yep.
Something.
Sure.
Fat will have another problem, which is that it will retain fat soluble toxins. And so the environment in which they grow this thing better be incredibly pure of those things.
It's got nooks and crannies.
It does have nooks and crannies in which toxins could hide. Yep. But when they get around to other types of flesh, muscle, presumably, now probably.
So their argument appears to be from a market perspective, from a doing less harm to the animal perspective, so much of the flavor rides in the fat.
Yeah.
That we can use entirely plant protein and only use animal fat. I don't have any interest in such a product, but even if that all could be done, if all of the problems that we have already listed and many more that we haven't didn't exist, that feels... like a possibility that like the flavor does come in the fat and they can then get the mouthfeel.
Yeah. I mean, they have picked the animal in which this is the truest.
Oh, absolutely.
Flavor you're going to get from, bacon fat. Is
Your house smells like bacon 3 hours later. It doesn't really smell like chicken 3 hours later unless you made an error.
Right.
Yeah.
Now, the last thing I would say is, let's say that they did it some other way, as you're suggesting, they kept reharvesting, which isn't going to make any sense because the hay flick limit isn't that high. But let's say that they did that.
Yeah.
Then the question is, well, exactly what problem are you solving? The only way this solves a problem is that if one animal can produce, indefinitely large quantities of the product,
right.
In which case you're going to have this issue. Any other way, A, you're going to have animals living longer under nasty conditions where they have, liposuction repeatedly, which can't be fun. So somehow it's just off. But
svelte pigs.
The You got to learn to read an article like that, because what it is a sales brochure.
Oh, sure.
Sales brochure disguised as journalism.
Yeah.
Presumably the journalist who wrote it doesn't even realize that that's what they've done. But the point is, if you want to give a fancy gloss to this technology that emphasizes the positive sides and obscures absolutely every legitimate question that you would ask about it, well, it would sound like this. So,
yep.
Anyway, you heard it here first. Might be a decade and a half before we finally start getting an inkling that it's going to be carcinogenic, but that is what I would expect, and I would treat it as such in the meantime. The fact that it's gross will help you.
Yes. I don't know. I really want to eat that. No, actually, I don't.
No, you don't.
Okay. So many reasons. Really All the don't. Reasons don't want to eat that.
Have a garbanzo bean.
Seriously. And a steak.
Yeah, and a steak.
Yeah.